little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl. Go, 50 in the house, bounce. Y'all already know what I'm about. The flow sounds sick over Dre drums. I ain't stupid, I see Doc. Then my dough come quicker. Whoa, shorty hips is hypnotic. She moves, she's so erotic. Watch, I'm like, bounce that ass, girl. I get it crump in here. I make it jump in here. Front in here, we'll thump in here. Oh, I'm so gutter, so ghetto, so hood. So gully, so grimy, what's good? Outside the Benz on dubs, I'm in the club with the snub. Don't start nothing, it won't be nothing. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl.
Let's party, everybody stand up. Everybody put your hands up. Let's party, everybody bounce with me. Some champagne and burn a little greenery. It's hot. Disco inferno, let's go. You're now rocking with a pro. I get dough to flip dough to get mo for show. Get my drink on and get on the dance floor. Look at me, I don't dance, all I do is this. It's the same two-step with a little twist. Listen, peppin', I ain't new to this, I'm true to this. Pay attention, boy, I teach you how to do this. We mix a little Chris with a little Dom Perignon and a little Hennessy, you know we finna carry on. Smiling at the streets in the club trying to get right. We gon' be up in this till we break daylight.
Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl.
You see me shining, lit up with diamonds, cause I stay grinding. Homie, you could catch me swooping, Bentley cooping, switching lanes. See me rolling, you know I'm holding. I'm out my paper. Yeah, I'm serious, I ain't playing. I'll embed it in your brain, I'm off the chain.
G unit,
next level now, turn it up a notch. Em and Dre sent me to tear up the spot. Front on me, oh no, you know I'm loco. Hands up on the dance floor, okay, let's go.
Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you're moving. Go ahead, put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl.
BBC Radio Berkshire.
BBC Radio Berkshire, Madonna, Like a Prayer. I love when the choir gets going on that song and it just lifts and lifts and lifts, doesn't it? Hello, it's Kirsten O'Brien with you. Friday, and talent is never in short supply here in Berkshire. We have people from our area flying the flag in all sorts of competitions, from the World Cup to the Olympics. If you can compete in it, you can be darn sure someone from Berkshire is involved somewhere along the line. However, this may be a new one, even for us. A potential young cheesemonger of the year is here. This competition will be fought out this year in the Portuguese city of Viseu, and representing Berkshire, Jack Welch of the Pangbourne Cheese Shop joins me now. Hi.
Hi.
How has this happened? How have you ended up in this situation? Congratulations so far.
Thank you. Yeah, it sort of happened fairly suddenly, actually. Applied about 2 months ago, and yeah, I got the email a couple of weeks ago that I'll be going out to Portugal, and yeah, very exciting.
What's the application process then? What do you have to demonstrate on that?
So you have to create a kind of like hypothetical cheese board, obviously with real cheeses, but some pairings, and then they look at this, and yeah, a couple of other things as well. And yeah, just, yeah, I got chosen as the final six, I believe. I think there's five others.
And how young do you have to be the young cheesemonger?
Under 30.
Under 30.
Yeah, made it by 3 months.
So, yeah. And are there many of you out there? How competitive is it?
Yeah, I'm not sure actually how many people like applied. It's all done by the Academy of Cheese, who are kind of like the group who oversee everything, including the World Cheese Awards. So I was lucky enough to be chosen, and I'm not sure how many people applied, but down to the final six.
And do you know who you're up against? Are they sort of worldwide people?
Four are British, so a couple are based in London, and two are from Australia. So, yeah, they're flying all the way from Australia to Portugal. So,
and when you get to Portugal, what happens there?
I fly out on the Thursday, and then I'll be competing the next day on the Friday, which is the 15th of November, I think. I think it's going to be like a meet and greet sort of thing on the Thursday evening. I'm not really too sure. I'm kind of, excited to see how it's going to unfold. But I know Friday is actually competition day, so yeah.
And what does that consist of? What do you do on that day? And does it whiff in that room?
I'm not sure. It probably does, yeah. Yeah, it probably does. I could imagine. If it's anything like our shop, then yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, so it'll be a quiz, a Master Rind quiz, so that's general knowledge.
Stop, you just glossed over that. Master Rind,
yeah,
genius.
Master Rind, yeah.
Love
yeah.
it, right. So you got the quiz.
And then the cheese board that I put in the application, I will be talking through that. So that'll be some local Berkshire cheeses.
So do you have to physically take those out, the cheeses?
They'll be provided, I believe. I don't actually have to bring those. I just have to talk about them and like describe why I've chosen these cheeses. But there's another one which is like pairings. So there's a short list of about eight cheeses, and I have to choose a pairings with a cracker and one like accompaniment, such as like fruit or
a chutney.
Yeah, chutney, exactly. Yeah.
And what have you chosen then? Are we allowed to know what is on your cheese?
I haven't actually chosen it yet. No, I'm working on it.
You're
I was having a little think yesterday. I must been chatting with my colleagues as well, who are a lot of experience. We're kind of getting some ideas together, and I've shortlisted some. So,
and would you want to showcase a variety, like a hard cheese, something gooey, and is that the point?
I think it's like a case of having like a variation of cheeses. So, I mean, there's like pairing. I mean, a lot of it is personal preference. There isn't like a right or wrong answer to pairings, but I think it's definitely probably a good variation of cheeses is always good, rather than just having pure hard cheeses, and showing kind of a bit more of a wider skill set.
And Berkshire's not particularly known for our cheeses, are we? Are you able to represent Berkshire in any way in that?
Yeah, absolutely. There's some great cheeses made in Berkshire and South Oxfordshire as well. Couple of really amazing dairies. I've got some here with me now. And,
I'm eyeing the cheese. I'm going to have a bit of a tasting next. So do you have an absolute favourite cheese?
I do. It changes, but I really like sheep's milk cheeses. Something that I hadn't really tried before. I kind of got into the cheese game, but yeah, there's some really amazing cheeses around, and Wigmore, which is like the brother of this Waterloo here that I have made by the same dairy. That's probably my favourite, yeah.
How did you get into what I like you call the cheese game?
The cheese game.
How did you get into the cheese game?
Yeah.
How did it start for you?
Kind of just by chance, really. I just applied for a role in the shop, and yeah, the owners, Jen and Ali, were kind enough to give me an opportunity, and yeah, it's been like a year and a half now, I think I've been there almost. So yeah, it's been fun, and yeah, learning a lot is so much to learn. There's crazy the amount of cheeses there are and all the different things you have to learn. We sell about 140 cheeses, so I think I've just about got them down.
140 but, yeah. Different ones, goodness right, me. Well, yeah. You've brought, as you say, a few into the studio, so I shall learn all about those, and I get to taste some cheese as well for a Friday. We'll do that next on BBC Radio Berkshire with
cheat.